Good morning, everybody. It is Monday. I can't believe June has flashed by so fast. So I'm down here at the beach, Oak Island, Long Beach, North Carolina, 28465 zip code, if you want to check out where we're at. And we're going to start a rubber roof. We're going to start another rubber roof. And I'm getting ready to show you this thing is actually already is a rubber roof. But they did a terrible job on it. So we're going to make it right. When they did this metal roof, they did this way. No overhang whatsoever. Not only did they not put an overhang on it when they attached their rubber to the outside here, there just wasn't enough left on it so that when this stuff shrank, it pulled right through the screw holes. Look how far that screw hole is back. All the way to there, down to here. So that's how far it shrunk. And this stuff will shrink and get really nice and tight. But you have to use, number one, I don't use that type of turn bar because it's smooth and without the ridges on it, has nothing to grab a hold of. So you wanna make sure that you leave a little bit of rubber under that. But the other thing is they didn't put any plywood on this thing. And yeah, they didn't glue the rubber down. It's been up here for over 10 years, just like this. So whoever did, it's been here for 10 years. Yeah, I had it done 10 years ago, and they didn't have a problem until the rubber started, you know, it shrinks. This rubber will shrink, especially have problems if you don't glue it down, okay? But if you are looking to get your rubber roof done and you just cannot afford my way, this is a option for you. I would definitely leave a little bit of extra rubber down here. But this roof could be put on any mobile home with just the way they did it. I would use a different type of termination bar, some that had ridges on it so that it would grab a hold real good, and leave a little bit of extra rubber down here and glue this. You could glue this to your roof. If you don't put plywood down, you could glue it to the roof. My very first one I did, we glued it to the roof. And I learned how to do it better later on, but my first one, I just glued the rubber just like this to the roof as they didn't glue it here. If they had have, it wouldn't have shrunk here so bad at the edges and pulled loose. So this roof would still be working for them if they had glued it. But without the glue, it just shrunk. And as it shrunk, it pulled out from the termination bar. So this is an option to do your roof if you don't want to do the overhang part. I just recommend, like I said, to leave rubber at the bottom and glue it down to the metal itself. I mean, it's not the best way, but it will work. This has been here for over 10 years. We're getting ready to remove this, all of it. We're gonna just cut it off here at the edges, get rid of the rubber, install our OSB like we do with our 6-inch overhang. Except for on the porch area. The porch area has rubber, but underneath that rubber is that, what do they call that? Peel and seal rolled roofing? It's like a peel and seal. It's got the granules on it. Let me see if I can get over and show you. This is what they had done originally. And then it leaked. So they hired somebody to put this rubber on it. But this is the original rubber roof. And this is on plywood. I mean, this is the original roof that they put to the house. There it is. See that? It's that rolled roofing with the granules on it. And we're just going to peel that off. Do our best job to peel it off anyways. Peel that off tomorrow, and we're going to put rubber roofing on this. Rubber roofing on the whole thing. So if you want to see us do another rubber roof, we've done bunches of them. I'll try to get as much of the detail as I can on this thing. Show you how to do your own. But you could literally do your own and do it their way. They got 10 years out of it, 10 good years. Never had an issue, but it peeled loose because it is not glued to the roof. So I would suggest gluing it to the metal itself for an easy 10 year, 15 year fix on your roof. That would work, but my method, I'm saying will last 30 years. So going the extra mile makes all the difference in the world. I'll see you tomorrow when I download the next video. Hit that bell notification so you're notified when I download it. It's coming soon.
This is some of my material. I used Carlisle 45 mil non-reinforced termination screws for the outside metal. And this is what you want to use for glue if you're gluing down to the metal or OSB or whatever. Acrylic, water-based, bonding adhesive. $230 per bucket.